Joining me now is Theresa Cardinal Brown, Director of Immigration and Cross-Border Policy at the Bipartisan Policy Center. Theresa, welcome back to our broadcast.
Glad to be here, Lauren.
The human toll, that's really what this picture shows. And according to the Border Patrol figures, 283 people died along that southwest border in 2018. Nearly 100 of those deaths were in the Rio Grande, and that number is holding those deaths this year. So what is to be done? I know you think you have a solution.
Well, there's a lot of things that need to be done. One thing I will say is that it is absolutely a tragedy. Those deaths that are reported at Border Patrol are the ones we know about. There are probably many more that we don't. And I think what you heard the senator say is it does talk about the desperation of the migrants to get to the United States. First and foremost, we need to take care of the migrants that are coming now. The conditions in which they're at the border, even the Border Patrol admits that they are not in facilities that were meant to handle families and children. They are way overcrowded, and that's what Congress is considering. Well, so that's first and foremost. But secondly, we need some additional help and authorities. There hasn't been the kind of coordination among all the government agencies that's usually needed when you have a humanitarian crisis, such as a natural disaster. FEMA hasn't been involved at that level. There are other things that we can do to try to address that.
Well, we keep hearing so much about the squalor, the condition for these children being housed in these government facilities. And you're saying that there isn't management at the top about how to help them. We've heard reports of volunteers showing up with donations, but they can't be accepted. Is that?
Yeah, that's one of the things. The government is not allowed to accept private sector donations in most cases. So the government has this thing that says that a law that says that they can't spend money, and that includes donated money or things that haven't been appropriated by Congress. So Congress appropriates the money and then they can spend it. The only exception to that is in the result of a natural disaster. FEMA does
and
have
that's
specific
your FEMA.
Authorities.
There you
yes.
go. So now you're saying if FEMA gets involved, the organization that helps with hurricanes and providing aid and disaster relief, that then maybe that is something that could help them. Let's talk about Wayfair workers. They walked off the job today in protests over sales of beds to border centers. You can see them here. Mm-hmm. They say they're voting their conscience by saying that Wayfair should not be sending these beds to the border.
Well, I think there's a conflation between what's known as Immigration Customs Enforcement or ICE detention, which is where migrants that after they leave the border area sometimes are held, and what's going on there. And you heard members of Congress talk earlier about not funding detention. But that's different than when CBP encounters people immediately. Yeah, Border Patrol, they encounter these people immediately after crossing. They have to have some place to put them for the length of time it takes for that initial processing. This is not ICE. This is not detention. This is just some place to house them. And the facilities they have are not meant for families and kids. They don't have beds. So while I might sympathize with the desire to address the longer term detention needs, right now sending beds to the border so these kids have a place to sleep might not be a bad idea.
Theresa Cardinal Brown, Director of Immigration and Cross-Border Policy at the Bipartisan Policy Center. Thank you.